Hi, this is Chucky at Electric Festival Aruba 2014, and this is Love This City TV.
Mel here with Love This City TV. We are in Aruba for Electric Fest Aruba, and ADE is here as well, and I'm here with Chucky. We're going to touch base about everything regarding this festival. This is amazing. The Caribbean has not seen anything like this, and we are so excited to be here. Why don't you tell us a little about this?
Yeah, so it's the second year for Electric Festival in Aruba, and I'm really excited. You know, obviously we stepped up our game as far as production, and we, you know, put in a lot of work to get the whole conference thing going, more engagement with ADE, with the Amsterdam Dance Event. The panel's looking great, you know, the conference is amazing, and obviously, you know, a lot of people from all over the Caribbean actually flew in. We even had people from Europe and Canada coming in. It's been amazing so far, and right now Carnage is about to go on the decks, and I think it's gonna be a crazy night.
Amazing. So right now this is day one of the actual festival, but we're now in day three actually of the festival overall. Why don't you tell us a little bit how you made this festival this year 5 days as opposed to three last year? What made you guys come up with that concept?
Well, apparently, you know, people from the Caribbean, they can't party enough, you know. So like last year it was a little bit too short. We needed more. So of course, because we extended the whole conference thing with ADE, you know, we needed more days because we have so many people and experts trying to share their expertise and their knowledge and stuff, that, you know, we needed a bigger platform and therefore more days. So that's why we kicked off with Loco Dice with a great grand opening party. It was amazing. Also groundbreaking because, you know, it's underground, and the whole techno scene is still, actually electronic music in general is new in the Caribbean, you know. And then to have such a successful night with Loco Dice is really groundbreaking for this region. So that went well, and then we did a couple of panels yesterday, a couple of pool parties. I actually attended one today. It was like crazy. We had people from Colombia, Venezuela, Panama there, and the vibe is just amazing. And you know, it's such a safe environment, such a nice environment. Everybody's just in a very relaxed mode.
The one thing I like about this is I've been to festivals all over the world, but here I find it's just like a happy-go-lucky. It's like happy people on that one little happy island, and that just makes it very niche. But moving into that, why don't you tell me a little bit about how you guys decided which artists you're going to bring? Because you have an incredible lineup this year. So how do you choose from headliners to newcomers to locals?
Well, the way it works for me, you know, Aruba has this logo called One Happy Island, and I'm trying to share these happy moments with people I really have a connection with. So first of all, for as far as the lineup, I really wanted to invite DJs I have a personal connection with, and that's why, like, me and Loco Dice have been friends for many years, and we shared great moments. So I wanted him to be here and come to Aruba and see what it's like, you know. And he succeeded. So I also invited like Knife Party and Little John and Carnage to share, you know, the same kind of moments. And yeah, they really loved it. And that's actually how I select the lineups. And of course, you know, I asked the people and I asked my colleagues who would you like to see here. So yeah, we came up with this little lineup. And as far as the locals, which is actually one of the most important things to me, to give them a main stage they never had, you know, and probably never would if our Electric Festival wasn't here. So we try to look at the guys that have a lot of potential, the guys that work hard locally, and the guys that really try to put themselves out there. And so we made a lineup, you know, and one of the guys playing right now is Carrickson, a really talented local producer. And then we also have Nuts Beach playing tomorrow with Knife Party, also a really talented guy. So in this way we try to, yeah, it works both ways for everybody.
Amazing. So why don't we touch base a little bit on ADE? You guys brought them over here, it's their second year as well. This year they're going a little bit stronger than they were last year. How'd you guys build that relationship with them?
Well, we've been always been friends with ADE, you know, and I guess the ADE saw as well, because we definitely had the desire to, you know, to put something like the ADE in this region, because strategically Aruba is in between the Americas, so you know, it's really easy to get together on one nice island with palm trees and sun. You know, I mean, I don't have to explain to you how it looks like over here. So so we wanted to have a conference here, and then I think ADE saw the same possibilities, like, yo, you know, this strategically is in a really good place, so we should definitely do something with it. And I think we're really lucky and really happy to have them on board.
That's great. Yeah, you guys had some very interesting key speakers. Tell us a little, touch base on maybe your headliner speakers that you had this round.
We had some interesting people from all over the world. We had a guy, you know, from Harvard University talking about, you know, the connection between Dutch house and the actual Caribbean roots and music. We also had, of course, you know, Richa Selma, the director of ADE, talking. And like a lot of people from Europe talking about production, the way they do it. And that's also a really cool thing I would like to say is that, you know, we built the stage with a lot of local people to, you know, to pass on the knowledge we have. Yeah.
All right. So now that we've touched base on the festival, I got to ask you, you're going to be ripping up a dirty set today, if I'm not mistaken. What are you going to be playing for us? What can we expect? Any new beats, new music?
Yeah. I got a lot of new exciting tracks I want to play today. It's not like very sing-along kind of songs. It's just hard, dirty dance floor stuff, you know, and that's what I'll be doing.
That is exactly what we want to hear. We're going to let you go and we are going to dance to your music. We're so excited. Thank you for this festival. We appreciate it and you're the bomb.
Yeah.
Peace. I'm gonna do like something very quick with you. Now I think we gotta go face to face for this though. All right.